In this video, we're computing the integral of x squared e to the 2x. And this is an integration by parts integral where we have to repeatedly apply integration by parts before we get our final answer. And so the strategy is to continue to knock down the power of x squared until we eventually get a constant and we can wrap up the problem. To show you what I mean, we start with the substitution. Let u equal x squared. And we get the differential of that. Du is going to be 2x dx. The other part of the integral is dv, and that was e to the 2x dx. So we have to get the antiderivative of that to find v. And just using the chain rule backwards here, that's 1/2 e to the 2x. That's the thing I differentiate to get e to the 2x. The chain rule produces a factor of 2 to kill the factor of 1/2 out in front. Now we apply the integration by parts formula. So our original integral turns into u times v. That's 1/2 x squared e to the 2x minus the integral of v du. Now notice that v has a factor of 1/2 in it and du has a factor of 2 in it. So when I multiply v and du, those factors cancel. All I have left here is x e to the 2x dx. Now we have to apply integration by parts again. And this time I'm going to let u equal x. And this is what I mean by knocking down the power of x with each iteration of integration by parts. When I differentiate this, when I get the differential, it's du equals dx. Dv is the other part of the integral, which is an e to the 2x dx. We guess the antiderivative again using the chain rule backwards. And that's 1/2 e to the 2x. And we apply integration by parts again. Now this time we have a spectator term out in front. Right now we're computing this integral, but don't forget to copy down that spectator. We have minus this integral that we're computing by using parts again. So we get u times v, and that's a 1/2 x e to the 2x minus the integral of v du. And I realize I forgot to label 1/2 e to the 2x as v, so there's that. So that's my v, and then du is simply dx. So I end up with the integral of 1/2 e to the 2x dx. Now in this integral, again, I have to guess the antiderivative of e to the 2x, which is 1/2 e to the 2x. That gives me two factors of 1/2, giving me a 1/4. And as we're using the chain rule backwards casually like this, I'm always just checking in my head by using the derivative. The derivative of e to the 2x is 2e to the 2x. That cancels a factor of 2, and I get what I started with, so I know it works. So we'll clean things up, and I get a 1/2 x squared e to the 2x. I'm distributing the minus sign over these parentheses now, so I have a minus 1/2 x e to the 2x, and then a plus the result of this integral, which was 1/4 e to the 2x, and I need to put a plus c on that. And there's our integral. Now the second part of this question is to show that the derivative of this antiderivative we found gives back the original integrand. So that's one cool feature of indefinite integrals is you can always check your answer by using the derivative. So when we think about differentiating this result, it looks like we have to use the product rule on the first term and the second term. So two iterations of the product rule, that's kind of undesirable. And to avoid that, I'm going to factor out the e to the 2x. So I end up with e to the 2x times the quantity 1/2 x squared minus 1/2 x plus 1/4. And of course, there's a plus c on there that doesn't matter because when we differentiate that, we get 0. So what's the derivative of this? Now we have to use the product rule only once because I have this function e to the 2x out in front and this polynomial function in the parentheses. So to use the product rule, I take the derivative of the first function e to the 2x, and that gives me a 2e to the 2x, and I leave this polynomial alone. Then I have a term where I leave the e to the 2x alone, and I take the derivative of this polynomial. And the derivative of 1/2 x squared, you just bring down the power of 2, and I just get x. The derivative of negative 1/2 x, that's just negative 1/2, and the derivative of 1/4 is 0, and the derivative of c is 0. So there's our first derivative. Our challenge here is to show that that's equal to the original integrand. So certainly I can pull the e to the 2x out of the whole thing. And for this first term, I had a 2e to the 2x times this polynomial. Well, I can distribute the 2 into it at the same time I'm writing down the next step. And this gives me an x squared minus x. And then in my second term, I pulled an e to the 2x out of e to the 2x times x minus 1/2, leaving me with a plus x and minus 1/2. Now I combine like terms, negative x plus x, those are gone. 1/2 minus 1/2, those are gone. And I end up with only x squared e to the 2x remaining. And that's my original integrand, verifying that our answer for the antiderivative was correct. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.